Sorry for the wait.
Oh, we weren't waiting long at all. Is there something else you wanted to tell us?
No, I don't have anything new to share. I just felt that since you were my investigation partners, I should have another conversation with the two of you. Traveler, how would you have responded to Baptiste's request if you were in my shoes? Is that so? Well, thanks for sharing. When I was young, my father often took me here to swim. We'd come rain or shine, even when it was freezing cold. He told me that swimming was the best activity to train one's strength of will. You could never give up before reaching the shore, especially when the water was cold.
Oh? Why is that?
Because the moment you give up would be the moment you die. At that point, I still hadn't received my vision. One winter, the chilly wind felt almost like knives on my skin, and the seawater was so frigid that it numbed my toes the moment I stepped in. I cried and begged my father to spare me from having to swim across, but he wouldn't listen. He used to be a member of the Special Patrol as well. You could say it was his way of educating his children.
That sounds awful.
When he saw that I wouldn't stop crying, he just picked me up and tossed me into the icy water. The bone-chilling cold took away my senses. I couldn't feel anything but fear and rage. I waited for my father to save me, but one look and I knew he'd already started swimming for the opposite shore. I realized that if I were to give up, I really would die right then and there. I used all of my strength to try and catch up to my father. Those few minutes felt longer than my whole life up until that point. I did, however, make it to the other side. I've never felt afraid about anything in my life after that, nor have I ever cried again.
That way of teaching would have never worked on Paimon.
Yeah, I don't think that was the right method for anyone. It's just that, working now as I am in the pursuit of justice, I still sometimes feel like I've been tossed into that winter sea all over again. The anger and the helplessness.
Chevres.
But the worse I feel, the more I know to never give up. The alternative would be to forever lose myself among the waves. Anyway, how about a race? Neither of us will drown, but we can still see who swims faster.
You guys go ahead! Paimon will grab the clapperboard to mark the start of the race!
Sorry for the wait.
Oh, we weren't waiting.
No, I don't have anything new to share. I just felt that... Traveler, how would you have responded to Baptiste's request if you were in my shoes? When I was young, my father often took... He told me that...
Oh?
Because the moment you... One winter, I cried and...
That sounds...
When he saw that I would... The bone chilling... I waited for my... I used all... I've never felt afraid about any...
That way of teaching...
Yeah, I don't think that was the right... It's just that... Working now as I am in the pursuit of justice, I still sometimes feel like I've been tossed into that winter sea all over again. The anger and the helplessness.
Chevres.
But the worse I feel, the more I know to never give up. The alternative would be to forever lose myself among the waves. Anyway, how about a race? Neither of us will drown, but we can still see who swims faster.
Thank you.
Oh, that felt good.
You were so fast in the water, Chevres. You were swimming even faster than Paimon could fly. So, about the Special Patrol, did you join because of your dad?
Partly, but I'd say I was more inspired by the heroes I read about in stories growing up.
Oh, so it's due to your love of stories.
Of course, it was only after I joined the Special Patrol that I learned that truth is often stranger than fiction. Come on, let's walk a bit more. To be honest, I do sometimes question whether the decisions I make are the right ones. But I know that no matter what, I must keep swimming. Because the only thing I've got my eyes on is the shore in the distance. Thank you for coming on this walk with me. I feel a lot better after getting all that off my chest.
Huh. We're nearly back at Baptiste's house.
Huh. You're right. I didn't realize we were so close.
He really did plant a lot of flowers. It's just like how he described it in the story.
Huh? Wait. Paimon, Traveler, look! The rainbow roses in the garden. They're in full bloom now.
Hey there, you two! Sorry I've been scarce. I've been buried in marketing and preparing the film for release ever since we wrapped post-production.
The award ceremony is today, right? Paimon wonders if we'll win the Farina Award!
I'd give it a 90% chance.
Farina! Oh, Paimon didn't know you were already here! You're earlier than everyone else!
I'm sure the others will also be here in no time. Xavier, If we end up getting called on stage, shouldn't you come up with a name for our crew?
What? But we don't even know if we're going to win. I wouldn't want to jinx our chances by celebrating early.
Just open your eyes! Surely you've seen the audience's reactions to our film. We've had nothing but critical acclaim. You've also had conversations with the Opera House's operating staff, right? Didn't they want to increase the number of showings? With the mora you've made from the box office, you can now open your very own film company!
But that's all credit to my amazing crew! You've all helped to make this a reality, so I can't be the only one asked to come up with a name.
Well, give it some thought. I'm sure the crew will respect your choice.
All right, but before that, Traveler and Paimon, could I trouble you to quickly pay a visit to the Fortress of Meripede?
Huh? But shouldn't we stay for the award ceremony?
I wanted to ask you two to invite Shavraz to join us at the ceremony. She's one of the lead roles, after all. I haven't been able to find her recently, so I haven't had the chance to invite her personally. According to the papers, the culprits of the musket murder case will be personally escorted today by the captain of the special patrol to the Fortress of Meripede.
Oh, Paimon gets it now. Yep, just wait here, Xavier! And maybe try to come up with a few snappy-sounding names.
All right, then I'll leave you to it.
If you're not sure what to do next, how about I take you on a walk?
This is as far as I'll be taking them. I'll leave the three of them to you now.
Got another errand to run?
Something like that. I'm expected at a party.
Now that's something you don't hear every day. Found a new pastime?
No, it's just a special occasion.
Shavraz! Risley!
Festivals really do bring people together. It's been a while since I last had so many visitors at the Fortress of Meripede.
Call it the festival spirit, I guess.
Yeah, you could say that. Even our head nurse has gotten herself all worked up preparing super deluxe nutritious shakes. Just one gulp and you'll have met all your nutrition needs.
Were you talking about work just now?
We've already finished discussing everything. So, what do you think about my heads up, Mr. Risley?
I believe I haven't yet made any promises or guarantees.
But you also didn't shoot me down. Here. How about this? You could give everyone a copy of the newspaper. Perhaps on the day when the cover story happens to, oh, I don't know, expose a certain someone's misdeeds from 20 years ago?
I suppose then a certain someone may soon find himself the most unlucky person in the Fortress of Meripede?
While another two people will soon be hailed as heroes.
Speaking of heroes, did you two need something from me?
Actually, we're
You're here to invite me to the party, right? Don't worry, I didn't forget.
Ooh, then let's head back right away! See you, Risley! Happy Fontanalia Festival!
And the same to you.
And the winner of the Farina Award for the first Fontanalia Film Festival is... The Two Musketeers!
We won! We really won!
Congratulations, Mr. Xavier.
We won? I can't believe it! I really can't thank all of you enough!
See? My takes on Fontaine's entertainment industry have never been wrong.
Now, please welcome to the stage the producer of The Two Musketeers, Mr. Xavier!
Thank you! Thank you all so much for your recognition and support. While I'm up here, I would love to give special thanks to...
Time really flies, huh?
It certainly feels that way. It feels like it was only yesterday when you were teaching me to hold a musket.
Will you come back to Fontaine again?
Of course! I'm very fond of this city. There are so many novel and interesting things that it's been hard to keep track of them all. But how about you? Would you be interested in visiting Inazuma?
I can't say the thought has crossed my mind before, but I'd be willing to consider it now.
I will be eagerly awaiting your visit. It would be wonderful if you could visit my home and enjoy a taste of our tea and desserts.
Yeah, let's keep in touch.
Did you accomplish all you came here for?
Yes. And you should visit Inazuma again sometime.
How has Ogura and her business been?
To my knowledge, she's doing quite well.
Tell her I said hi.
I certainly will.
I heard the thunderstorm has stopped.
Yes, and the war has also been brought to an end. Peace and prosperity has returned to the island.
I quite like the sound of that. Perfect for hanging textiles out to dry.
I'd like to offer my thanks again to the entire cast and crew. Without you, I would have never completed this film, much less had the opportunity to be standing on this stage. With the support of my entire crew, I would like to officially announce our film company, Musketeer Pictures!
Ho-ho! That has a really nice ring to it.
Then in that case, let's please welcome all the members of Musketeer Pictures onto the stage for a commemorative photo.
Oh, Paimon didn't know we'd also be taking pictures.
Director Farina, I believe you are the most deserving person to raise this trophy.
Huh? No. There's no need. It's so embarrassing.
It's an honor the director deserves.
Yes, I agree.
Just accept that you're not getting out of this.
Ready, everyone? 3, 2, 1!
Musketeer Pictures!
Yeah. Thank you.
see everything.
Schedule.
Everyone hold hands.
Thank you. Next on the agenda. Way behind schedule. Healthy body, health. Next on the agenda. Next on the agenda. Next on the agenda.
Beautiful treasures are a cause for great...
Way behind schedule. We're way behind schedule. Next on the agenda. Thank you. We're way behind schedule. Let the wind lead. Thank you.
barricade!
There's nothing better to do. We could go foraging for ingredients.
Next on the agenda.
Thank you.
Frost. The air is just right. Next on the agenda. We're way behind schedule.
see everything.
Next on the agenda. On the agenda.
The air is just right. Thank you.
Stomach cramps. Race you!
Frost.
Hey!
We're way behind schedule.
You can't keep up with me!
Thank you. Hey, there's something strange over there. Come on, let's take a look.
Schedule.
Be epic.
I've been waiting for you for
your time.
escape.
Access denied.
Let's light it up.
Next on the agenda.
Sharing my knowledge.
All hail.
Be still. Mind the deluge.
Mm-hmm.